All right, guys, so we finally have the GoPro HERO Black 10 leaks for this year, and we got some juicy new frame rates and resolutions and specs, so I'm excited to break it down. Now, all of this is alleged information, so it could totally be false, so keep that in mind. But if it's true, we got some juicy details to cover. I'm Ben Schmanke from AllAuthenTech, and let's get right into it. Oh, and credit goes to Win Future for all of these leaks. Let's start with some of the exciting new features, what I'm really pumped about, and then some of the hesitations and wishlist items and thoughts that I have. Please, GoPro, don't screw this one up again. Let's start with the camera body design. It looks almost same, maybe exact same dimensions and specs, so it can fit the old media mod, hopefully. It shows that on the box. We have the same folding fingers underneath. This is one of my favorite features, so I actually like to see that. Looks to have the same chunky bezels as the old one, so that's sort of a bummer. And then lastly, it looks like we have got some blue lettering on the logo and on the side. I don't love it, I don't hate it. It's gonna be a good way to differentiate the 9 from the 10. I even polled you guys on my Instagram, and it looks like a slight majority actually kind of like the blue. So there you go, it's personal preference. Now, even more important than the camera body, we now have the packaging leaked. And if it's true, we finally have a big bump up in some of the specs and resolutions, which I'm really excited about. Let's quick run through them. So first up, it looks like we finally get a new GP2 chip. That GP1 is like 4 years old, maybe older. It's caused so many problems with the GoPros in the lineup. So I'm really excited for that GP2, and I think that's gonna unlock a lot of these cool new capabilities. It says 23 megapixel sensor, which seems like a nice improvement. This old one was 20 megapixels, so bigger sensor is gonna help with some maybe stabilization and other abilities. It says 5.3K at 60 FPS, which is pretty insane. This one was shooting at 5K 30 FPS, and I actually really liked and saw the differences in the clarity in that 5K versus the 4K. So to double that frame rate is super welcomed by me. I'm excited for that. Now, even more insane, almost seems too good to be true, is 4K 120 FPS, which is pretty nutty. For years, we've been stuck at 4K 60 FPS. Even my iPhone can shoot 4K 60 on the ultra wide. So to finally have a big differentiator for that, to slow-mo at least 4x at 4K good resolution, that seemed really exciting. That might be one of the banner features in my opinion. Oh, and hopefully stabilization is still gonna be good at 4K 120. A few other tidbits on the box, it says it's capped at 8x slow-mo, which we've had in the past. However, that used to be at 1080p 240. Now, it looks like 2.7K at 240 FPS, which is pretty awesome. You're getting that good resolution and 8x slow-mo, which is really sweet. Now, I would have loved to see even that 1080 at 480 FPS to double it once more, but doesn't seem like we're gonna get that this year. Also on the box, it says the same Time Warp 3.0, which is kind of odd because it also says HyperSmooth 4.0, which seems to have a bump up, which is really cool. Now, I'm excited and hopeful that we finally have Horizon Lock without a media mod needed. Maybe with that bigger sensor, I'm not sure. Even the Go 2, I just made a video on this thing. Whichever way you mount it or hold it, you're gonna have that locked horizon if you turn it on, which is an awesome feature to have. Looks to have the same waterproofing as before, same 1080p live streaming. Okay, a couple of wishlist items and hopes I have. I'm really hoping GoPro has figured out the bugs and the constant freezing issues. I've lost so much footage on this HERO 9, it is so frustrating. Hopefully with that new GP2 chip, it'll make the menus a lot more faster and responsive, not sluggish, less freezing. As for release date, well, it's always usually mid-September or around mid-October, somewhere in there. So we could just be a few weeks away. Make sure you guys are subscribed and maybe even turn on that bell notification if you wanna stay up to date when I post my brutally honest review. Remember, I don't get them sent to me for free early. I purchase some and I'm giving you all the pros and the cons, the true negatives that most others aren't talking about. So you don't want to miss that. As for pricing, that's not leaked either, but I'm guessing it's going to be same as last year's HERO 9, which was $450, I believe. And I'm also guessing they're going to do that scammy auto subscription thing to get a discount down to $400, I think it was. That's my guess anyway. Now, a few other big notes. Are we going to get a new DJI Osmo Action 2 this year? I'm really hoping so. It's been forever since they updated this old dog, and it's actually kept up to most of the GoPro lineup really well. So maybe we gotta stay tuned to see what the 2 would look like. I see people asking and hoping for a HERO session, the old cube. I love that thing as well. Perfect for FPV drones and stuff like that. Whoops. and I don't think we're gonna get it. Now, if you're looking for a session, the Go 2 might be your best bet. Funny enough, it's so tiny and small, it mounts really well in those tight spaces. But as for session 2 or session 10, whatever, I don't think we'll see it. Another thing that people are looking forward to is the new Max 2 or whatever they call it. Now, I've done a lot of comparisons versus the Insta 360, 360 cameras, and honestly, I'd vote Insta 360 always wins. The app, the workflow, the quality, stabilization, stitch line, everything Insta 360 always won. So personally, I don't know if they're gonna launch a new one, and personally, I'm not sad about it because I never really thought it was a good winner. All right, so you guys will have to let me know what you think down below. Are you gonna pick up the new HERO 10? Will you buy one on launch date? Yes or no? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.